Western blotting, also called immunoblotting, allows researchers to determine levels of protein expression in a cell or tissue extract through antibody binding to a specific protein of interest. Although this technique is widely used and accepted, problems can occur that lead to suboptimal results, such as low signal or high background, resulting in blots that are difficult to interpret or quantitate. This is the second video in our two-part series on Western blotting. The first video, Western Blotting Protocol, provides a comprehensive Western blot procedure used in-house by cell signaling technology scientists to validate our antibodies. This second video provides a guide to help you troubleshoot, suggesting tips to help diagnose problems, and providing solutions to ensure you get the expected results in the shortest amount of time.
Before we begin, it's important to note that the single biggest contributing factor to Western blot success is the quality of the primary antibody.
Antibodies that are not properly validated and lack specificity will generate a poor signal or result in multiple bands on a blot, some of which are nonspecific. This can be the cause of misleading results and uncertainty as to whether you are detecting the correct protein or not. This is why we take antibody validation seriously. Antibodies from cell signaling technology are both produced and thoroughly validated in-house. The Western blots we show on our product web pages are performed in a number of cell lines and tissue samples with varying expression levels known from the literature. First, we ensure that the banding pattern corresponds to the molecular weights for the proteins described in the literature. Then, to verify whether bands can be induced or knocked down appropriately, we treat the cells with growth factors, chemical activators, chemical inhibitors, or siRNA to induce or inhibit expression. We also confirm phospho-specificity using phosphatase treatments that should eliminate all signals. Using all of these controls, we strive to supply the most specific and sensitive antibody possible for Western blotting.
We hope this careful validation will allow you in turn to be confident in your results and to reproducibly generate publication-quality Western blots.
CSD recommends always using a positive and negative control with each experiment. CST scientists have compiled a useful controls table that can be used as a starting point for many of our phospho antibodies. Control cell extracts are available to help you identify potential problems with the technique and to serve as valuable tools for potential troubleshooting.
Poor Western blot results can be generally classified as either low signal or high background. The signal is considered low for most targets if the protein of interest cannot be detected after a 30-second exposure of the blot to film. High background is defined as having a generally dark background or nonspecific bands appear after a 30-second exposure of the blot to film. There are a number of causes for low signal. The first cause of low signal can be the protein of interest is below detectable levels.
If this is due to minimal expression in the starting cell line or tissue sample, a side-by-side comparison using an alternate cell line may be necessary, or a chemical stimulation to induce expression may be needed. Secondly, undetectable protein can be caused by suboptimal sample preparation by not using the recommended lysis buffer with the required phosphatase inhibitors. CST offers optimized cell lysis buffers that already contain all phosphatase and protease inhibitors. However, we recommend adding 1 mmol PMSF immediately before use. We always recommend sonication to ensure total cell lysis and to shear the chromosomal DNA. We recommend 3 pulses for 10 seconds at 35 to 40% power, although optimal settings should be determined for each sonicator. Keep samples on ice between pulses. If you do not have access to a probe sonicator, you may pass your samples through a fine gauge needle. Thirdly, undetectable protein can also result from inadequate loading of lysate onto the gel. CST recommends loading 20 micrograms of protein lysate per lane. However, if protein levels are below detection, 40 micrograms or more of protein can be loaded, or an immunoprecipitation prior to running the SDS-PAGE may be necessary.
Low signal can stem from issues with the transfer step. We recommend always performing a wet transfer over alternative semi-dry transfer systems.
Please view our Western Blotting Protocol movie for a comparison of antibody performance with wet transfer versus alternative transfer systems. When troubleshooting a wet transfer, the problem can be either incomplete transfer or over-transfer. Incomplete transfer can be corrected by increasing the time and/or voltage. Prestained molecular weight marker can be a useful tool to visually check if a complete transfer has occurred. Over-transfer is common with very low molecular weight proteins, particularly if a 0.45 micrometer membrane is used. We recommend a 2-hour transfer at 70 volts using 0.22 micrometer membrane.
Excessive blocking or washing can also cause low signal. Blocking the membrane for too long can obscure antigenic epitopes and prevent the antibody from binding.
Block for 1 hour at room temperature, never overnight. Washing for longer than the recommended 3 times for 5 minutes is common and can result in reduced signal. This applies to the washing steps after the primary and secondary antibody incubations.
Phospho-specific antibodies are highly specific, but generally result in lower signal than total protein antibodies.
It is critical that phospho-specific antibodies be incubated with blots overnight at 4 degrees Celsius in the buffer recommended on the datasheet. It is also important to make sure that phosphatase inhibitors are added to the cell lysis buffer when using a phospho-antibody. The cell lysis buffer and RIPA buffer from CST already contain these inhibitors.
Lastly, low signal can be the result of improperly prepared signal-fire chemiluminescent detection reagent.
Remake the solution if necessary and use biotinylated protein markers detected with an anti-biotin HRP secondary antibody as a positive control. Also, leaving the chemiluminescent reagent open for extended periods will reduce the signal.
The starting material can be one of several causes of high background. In general, primary cell and tissue extracts tend to contain more background bands and degradation products than cell line extracts.
Using fresh, sonicated, and clarified tissue extracts may lessen the background. RIPA buffer number 9806 may provide a more thorough and consistent lysis of the tissue.
Insufficient membrane blocking and inadequate washing can result in high background.
Blocking for less than 1 hour or using another blocking buffer can result in nonspecific binding of primary and secondary antibody. For wash steps, using TBST buffer that contains the mild detergent Tween 20 helps remove nonspecifically bound proteins.
Proper dilution and incubation of the secondary antibody is important to minimize high background, as some secondary antibodies bind nonspecifically to proteins and cell extracts.
Always incubate the secondary antibody in 5% milk in TBST for 1 hour at room temperature. Diluting the secondary antibody in BSA results in high background. Serial dilutions of the secondary antibody can be performed on blots with the same cell extracts and primary antibody to optimize the secondary antibody concentration. CST offers secondary antibodies with predetermined optimal dilutions, saving you this troubleshooting step. These secondary antibodies are used in-house for antibody validation and are optimized to work with CST primary antibodies. To assess the quality of a secondary antibody, analyze a blot without primary antibody through the complete detection process.
Lastly, high background can occur at the detection step.
Long film exposure time due to low protein expression can result in high background noise. It is typically not necessary to expose the film for more than 30 seconds. Using a higher expressing cell line or inducing expression with chemical treatment can correct this problem.
And finally, it's important to remember that not all detection systems are the same. Digital imaging is often less sensitive than film. Please see our Western Blotting white paper on our website for more details on this topic. In closing, we hope this video is a helpful resource for performing Western blots using CST antibodies in your own lab. Please view our first video for a comprehensive Western blot procedure. Cell signaling technology provides itself in providing you with exceptional customer service and support. Since all of our antibodies are produced in-house, the same scientists who develop and assay these reagents are available as technical resources for our customers. These scientists can be contacted directly and will personally provide technical assistance to you, our customer.